Oh shit. Shit. God damn. Damn, man, that's one hell of a way to start off a motherfucking vlog. Stall the fuck out at a motherfucking light. God damn it.
Rated M for mature.
Oh well, how's it going, YouTube fam, man? Boy, Psychotic Heart here. And I got something that kind of pissed me off just now, you know? Other than stalling out at the fucking light and how magnificent that I stalled out at the fucking light the moment a sheriff passes by me, you know? Fuck. Alright, buddy, get your stretch on over there, okay? Alright, so like I was saying, I got something that was just on my fucking mind that just really pissed me the fuck off a little while ago, okay? Excuse me. Let me give y'all some history about what's going on here. So, this was a few months back, right? Me and my wife, we're up at the bank. If I'm not mistaken, we were withdrawing money from one bank to go put into our other bank. Like, we both have our own bank accounts, and then we have a joint bank account. So, we were both taking money out of our personal bank accounts to put into our joint account to pay our bills and stuff, right? So, we go to the bank, we take out the money, and here we go, walking back to the car. And suddenly this old dude on a bicycle comes riding up to us. It's obvious that he doesn't have a home, so I felt really bad for the man because it was obvious that he was homeless and stuff, but despite him not having a home and no homo, that motherfucker was in some great goddamn shape. That motherfucker biceps were bigger than mine. So I was like, how the fuck? I was like, damn, bro, you said fuck being homeless. I may be homeless, but I ain't gonna be raggedy. Shit, I mean, his clothes weren't that good, but yo, buddy was jacked, bro. Any fucking ways. What the fuck pissed me off was, now, he came out asking for a few dollars and stuff so he can try to get somewhere and get body and stuff, right? So I was like, all right, cool, I just do some money. And I actually got some singles on me. If I'm not mistaken, me and my wife both gave him like $5, right? So he was real thankful. He was saying, thanking all this, that, and the other and stuff. And then we get to talk about random stuff, about how he used to be married and he pretty much lost everything and divorced to his wife, fuck that red light. But anyways, oh yeah. So we talking, and some way or another, we got on a topic about motorcycles, right? So when we got on that topic, I was like, yeah, man, I ride motorcycles. I love to ride. It's one of the things I enjoy out of life. My wife doesn't like it. She never wanted me to get a motorcycle. However, getting a motorcycle is something I wanted to do since I was a fucking child, okay? So I wanted a motorcycle before I even knew my damn wife. So I'm sorry, baby, I love you, but when it comes to things I wanted before I got with you, do not expect me to give up on those, okay? That's just how it is. I may be a bit of a jerk, an asshole, dick, where the fuck anybody want to call me, I don't give a damn, okay? It's my fucking life. Life is too goddamn short to be trying to please everyone else 100%. I'm not finna be around here trying to constantly keep my wife happy if I'm miserable as shit, okay? Fuck that. I would divorce her in a heartbeat instead of doing something like that. I'm not gonna try to keep her happy while I'm miserable as shit. And you see me coming, but you're riding anyways, what the fuck ever, I don't care, but you turn down in front of me, so you're a fucking dick. I may be an asshole because of what I'm saying, but I don't give a damn. Because like I said, I was just reminiscing this shit and it really pissed me off. So, that's what we're saying. We're getting on top of motorcycles. I mentioned how my wife doesn't like me riding motorcycles. From that point, oh my God, when I tell you, this man went full motherfucking preacher mode on me, man. Like, oh man, that's not right, man, you know? It's obvious you love your wife, she loves you. It's obvious she cares about you and she don't want you to ride motorcycles and you do it anyways despite her not wanting you to do it. That's kind of messed up, man. You should really give up the motorcycles, man. You shouldn't do it anymore. So, me, I was trying to remain calm and civilized. I didn't want to go full on psychotic mode on the guy, because if I would have, this is what I would have said. Yo, dude, I just gave you fucking money out of my goddamn pocket, okay? So I'm trying to help you out. Don't bring your motherfucking ass over here to me trying to tell me what the fuck I should and shouldn't goddamn it do. Yeah, I know my wife don't like me riding the goddamn motorcycles, but I already told her and I already got it through her head. She's not going to stop me from riding my motherfucking motorcycle. So don't bring your motherfucking ass over here talking all this shit, this and another, about what the fuck I should and shouldn't goddamn it do. All right? That's stuff I wanted to say, I was gonna say, But I restrained myself from that day because I was in a really good mood. It was payday. I got some extra money in my account because I put in a bit of overtime, so I was in a really good mood, so I held back. So I let him go in and finish his thing. He did it talking. Next thing you know, my wife starts crying because he's saying things and she's been saying stuff. And in my head, I'm like, God fucking damn it, you son of a bitch. Why the fuck did I help you? So, yeah, man, it's like, damn. And then I asked. And then what? Another thing that saved him from my wrath was he said, yeah, man, I used to ride. So when he said that, that kind of calmed me down a little bit. Because, look, man, if you're somebody who don't ride motorcycles, who has never ridden a motorcycle, a dirt bike, a four-wheeler, or any other two-wheel or ATV vehicle, don't you dare bring your goddamn motherfucking ass in my fucking face telling me to give up riding my goddamn motorcycle, because if you do, I will curse you the fuck out or I will beat your fucking ass, because that kind of shit really gets on my fucking nerves, okay? If you're not someone who rides, if you're not someone who's ever ridden before, shut your fucking mouth and let us do what the fuck we want to do. Don't you think we know that getting on these fucking rocket ships every fucking day poses a considerable risk to our fucking lives, as well as our safety, because all these non-driving motherfuckers on the damn road, the drunks and all that other shit? We fucking know this. We acknowledge this. We fully understand this. We don't need you non-riding sons of bitches constantly fucking reminding us what the fucking dangers are to ride the fucking bikes, because all the fuck you're doing is jinxing us, making it seem like, oh, if you ride a motorcycle, this is going to happen. If you keep on riding, that's going to happen. At some point, this is going to happen. Hey, guess what? Bitch, you fucking jinxing the shit out of us. Shut your fucking mouth and let us ride our fucking bikes. Damn. Because, man, if you've ever seen this movie called The Secret, I saw this shit back in fucking high school, man. It's about, you know what, let me get in front of these motherfuckers, because I don't feel like waiting. Spanish River Boulevard, cool. Alright, this movie titled The Secret is about the secret to how to have a successful life and stuff, right? Now, the interesting thing is, this movie's based on the, what the fuck is that shit called? I think it's called The Law of, is it The Law of Attraction? Well, I forget what it's called specifically, but basically, if you constantly talk about something or you constantly wish for something, eventually it will happen. Okay? So the same as jinxing someone. So if someone's constantly in your face or in your ear saying you should stop riding or you shouldn't ride because you can get in an accident, you can fall, hit your head, if you don't wear gear, yada, 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 people are drunk, people are crazy, all that other shit. Like, damn it, dude, we know this stuff, okay? There's a reason we know this shit and we don't talk about it, because all it's doing is fucking jinxing us. Just like if you're riding and you suddenly start talking about, oh man, I ain't got no tickets yet, I do all this shit here, and the cop has to pull me over. Yeah, hey, guess what? Within the next week or so, chances are you're probably gonna get pulled the fuck over, you're probably gonna get a fucking ticket, and then you're gonna be really pissed the fuck off. Okay? That's the law of attraction. Or I think it's called the law of attraction. I don't remember specifically what it's called, but that's basically what it's about. If you continue to talk about something, eventually it will happen. That's basically what it is, okay? So, for those of you who have friends, family members, acquaintances, co-workers, or anything like that, and they start telling you about stop riding, you should give up because this can happen or that can happen, dude, do me a favor, tell them to shut their fucking mouth and go live their life, okay? Because I'm living my life and I know you guys are living your fucking lives. If you guys are watching this video, obviously, well, I can't say obviously because some of my viewers are children and whatever. Like I was saying, more than likely, if you're watching my videos, you're someone who rides motorcycles, okay? Chances are you're probably another moto vlogger yourself, okay? So, we need to all come together and just tell everyone to mind their fucking business. You know what? When I get shirts made, when I finally get around to getting me some clothes made for my channel, I'm gonna get a shirt, and on the back it's gonna say, yeah, I ride. I ride, so shut the fuck up if you don't ride. It'll be something along those lines. It'll be probably a picture of me on my motorcycle with my middle finger out just on the back and shit, and I'll say, I ride if you don't shut the fuck up, or something like that. Something along those lines. Something that just basically says that if you're not someone who rides a motorcycle like me, do not tell me that I shouldn't ride. Do not tell me what the dangers are of riding the fucking motorcycle, because I'm not a stupid motherfucker, and I'm sure as fuck not goddamn retarded. I know what the fuck the dangers are with riding a fucking motorcycle, so I don't need anyone constantly in my fucking ear telling me what the fuck could happen, okay? Jesus Christ. Anyways, you guys, that's all I wanted to comment with y'all about, man. I'm sorry if I blew some of your eardrums and shit out when I was doing my little yelling and stuff. But like I was saying, man, this is something that happened months ago. Like, we're in fucking September now. This shit happened way back in fucking March or April or May, somewhere around there. But I was just over here thinking about it, and that shit pissed me the fuck off. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, as usual, leave me a fucking like down below. Follow me on all my social media. Subscribe to my channel. And, yeah, that's going to be it for today, you guys. So, in the meantime, this is me, boys. So I got a heart and ass for the usual. Peace out, motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.